Getting it on Restream. Oh, there we go. Now I'm seeing it there. Yay! Good, great idea, Elena. You're so smart.
Sometimes I know what I'm doing. Rare occasion.
Grump birthday
Very
party.
Rare occasion.
All right, well, before we start, I'll turn to me and say, welcome, everybody. This is part three of our Halo 3 playthrough. I'm Adam Patrick Murray from PC World. We have Elena Yee on the line.
Woo! Hello.
Yay! And then Willis Lai is on the line as well. This is his first time through Halo 3. How you doing, Willis?
Hello.
Yeah, so let's hop right into it because we are on mission 8 of 11. We're not too far from the end. I'm pretty excited personally for the last level. But yeah, thanks to everyone for joining us on this Thursday. I'm tired, so hopefully I'm not too low energy.
That's okay. My plan is to let you guys do all the work and I'll just hang in the background where no one can see me anyway.
Oh, perfect. Well, let's watch this cutscene as we go in, and then once we start playing, I do want to ask about the Halo Infinite reveal. This music. I'd asked Willis earlier before we went online if he started listening to the soundtrack on his own yet.
We hit these three generators, and the barrier will
Spoilers, he hasn't, unfortunately.
Nope.
And Willis, did you get a chance to watch the Digital Foundry tech breakdown of Halo 3?
A little bit. I just kind of skimmed through it.
It's good. I love what Digital Foundry does.
Yeah. Pretty in-depth. Like, at least I saw the comparison between, like, the PC version, PC version versus Xbox.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Yay!
Oh, I'm down.
Oh, already?
I know, I was not paying attention to my...
Yay! Oh, no, I'm down.
Well, what happened?
What happened?
you got grenade.
I got grenaded. So yeah, now that we're in here, how about that infinite gameplay, huh?
Oh, so smooth.
Dude. Oh.
I'm not sure how I feel about the open world thing. The open map kind of thing.
Yeah, that's going to be new for Halo. I mean, that's a radical shift, depending on how open it is. I mean, they've talked about, like, instance-based kind of stuff, I think. Kind of like Destiny, so, I don't know how that plays out.
I was listening to IGN's post-show while I was getting ready for some meetings, and Miranda, one of my old coworkers, was saying that my game just froze.
Uh-oh, mine too.
I got kicked out.
Oh no, Willis. Check your fiber, dude. Check your fiber.
Oh man.
I know, you have fiber, man. What's up?
No, let me just...
Did you might need to do the gnat thing that we were talking about.
There you go.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh.
Anyway, Infinite. So they're saying that it's going to be not, I think, completely open world. It's still more like there's like a storyline, but you have like the option, I think, to go wander and explore. So it's not completely just freeform. It's my understanding.
Huh. Okay. I like it.
If I was listening to her correctly, I was admittedly trying to do multiple things at the same time.
Well, we are crashed. Yikes. And
crashed too?
Well, I mean, I'm like stuck at a loading screen. But we have just in time. We have Obi-Wan from Croatia. Hello, welcome.
Hello.
This is tantalizing a live
Hello,
stream
thanks
here.
Thanks for joining us.
I don't know what to do other than maybe hard.
While you're resolving that, just in case it's on Willis's end, Willis, you're on Windows 10, right?
Yes.
So go to the search menu, or like the. Just bring up the, just type in like gaming, and it should bring up the settings and the gaming subcategory, and then within that, choose the Xbox networking tab.
Gaming mode settings? Or...
Yeah, so it should be settings, gaming, and then Xbox networking.
Okay.
And what does it say under your Xbox Live multiplayer NAT type?
Let's see, loading. And Toretto is unable to qualify?
Yeah.
This
yeah.
will block you from...
Yeah, what? That happens. So click on fix it.
Okay.
And then wait for it to do its thing. And then it should tell...
What is that? What is that? Or what does that mean?
Toretto is like a service that helps, I guess, I don't know, it's part of the service with Xbox Live service for connection. I'd have to go look it back up what it is exactly. I didn't really bank it to memory.
Okay. Fixing it says suggesting that I should restart my computer, so...
What? It said to restart your computer?
It's suggesting. Because it's, yeah, it's...
Wait, can you share your screen real quick in our Zoom call?
Yeah. Okay. So...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Check again. Do you check again first just to see if that fixes it? Otherwise, you might have to actually... That's weird that you have to restart.
Rick said this is Microsoft's way of saying you should be preparing your body for Halo Infinite. Should be preparing okay. something, that's for sure.
Yeah, so yeah, maybe... I saw that, Willis. So yeah. When it does that, click fix it again and see if it tells you to reboot. And if you do need to reboot, just go ahead and reboot and we'll try this again.
Okay.
Sorry
about that, folks.
No, it's not a problem. It's just that because I'm guessing it's this is your problem. Just because, I mean, you and Adam both have gigabit connections, so that's not an issue at all.
Yep, telling me to just restart it.
So why don't you, if you can, why don't you restart and then rejoin us all in the Zoom call?
All right, BRB, folks.
All right. Yay for technical stuff. Wait, so where were you seeing that, Elena?
Oh, so I would suggest the same for you. So what you want to do is bring up the settings menu, the gaming section. You can just do, Windows search. Just type in gaming, and it'll bring you straight to that.
Oh, Windows.
Windows. Yeah, Windows.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll share my screen with you so you can see it.
We're still live, so.
Well, I know, but you're not.
Oh wait, what the hell?
Are you gonna be able to?
Well, no, because in order for me to see, I need to switch out of the game.
Oh, I see. Okay, never mind then.
Yeah.
Do you have the settings menu open?
Yeah.
You go to Xbox networking.
So Xbox.
So it should be settings, gaming, Xbox networking. Oh, I can see your screen. Great.
Xbox networking. Okay. Some live troubleshooting here.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Toretto is unable to qualify.
Yeah, so type the fix it.
It's still buried up.
Or sorry, click fix it, not type. Haha.
Fix it. Is this what you were talking about earlier on Slack?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's asking me to restart my PC.
You too?
Ooh, weird.
Crazy. Okay.
Check again to try reconnecting.
Well, you're connected to the server, so you're okay. Just click on check again, because it might open up your NAT.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Well, my NAT's moderate, which it's always been, but at least it's connected, so...
Okay, that's good enough then for now.
Okay.
Oh, at some point, we'll probably have to look at your router and figure out your NAT settings, UPnP settings and all that.
Yeah, I remember back in the 360 days, I remember having to learn how to open up ports on a router.
Yeah.
That was a long time ago. The sad thing is, I'm actually using a Razer router, so you would think that they would be able to open up those gaming ports.
It's a pain in the butt.
Well, at least I'm unlocking some tears while we're waiting. I don't even know what it's getting me.
For OXM, and it was the worst because trying to play online, like multiplayer type things from an office setting, and having to deal with the net issues there was just a nightmare. Because I mean, IT has their own way of doing things. They're not just going to start opening ports for us.
And oh well, yeah. Yeah, worst. I can only imagine. That's
it was so bad.
Is that Willis? Is he back?
Oh, it sounds like it. I hear
him. Yay! Well, I'm just sitting here unlocking all these tier rewards.
Yeah, I am.
For some reason, I have like a ton. Oh, okay, I'm done.
Oops. All right. I am multitasking right. Another window, doing some work. So y'all, let me know when you're ready to try again.
I'm launching Xbox now, or not Xbox, launching Steam now.
Cool.
Okay. Don't forget to check your the same settings.
Oh, okay.
Don't forget to check that, see if that's,
Recall.
All this appearance stuff. Huh. Weird. Okay, well. You know, it's all that grunt birthday party, you know?
Too much celebration.
Yeah. Hello, Casey Thomas. Halo is the best game. If only we could play it. Just, you know, just troubleshooting, don't worry. Eskimonster said this made them remember the days when they used DOS 5.0.
Really? Because this is still way more advanced than that.
I mean, I remember using DOS, like real basic stuff. Real basic stuff. I'm not gonna say I got deep into it at all, but playing some PC games back in what was that? Probably 93 on my parents' computer. Yeah.
I used DOS for years.
Okay, 6.0. I'm still getting the same issue.
Still?
Yeah.
Interesting. So we might have to look at your router later at some point, but hopefully Adam having cleared his thing, maybe it'll help bring things along.
I mean, it's the same setup as you know, our last gameplay. Haven't changed anything.
So. Oh, it's probably network settings. That's what I mean. It has nothing to do with the game itself.
Boy, oh boy.
He just means he hasn't changed anything on his router.
Yeah.
Right, I just mean we've had problems with him before, I think. It was him and Luis.
Hmm. Oh yeah. Well, I invited you to the game. Let's hope we can.
Let's hope that stays. Let me invite in. Okay.
Yep. All right. And I'm in. I just invited you, Elena.
Oh, I'm in.
Okie doke. Let's try this. One more time, folks.
Beep.
Yeah, maybe it just heard us talking about Halo Infinite. Maybe
Rick was right. Yeah. In my hearing.
Yeah, Halo 3's like, I'm still great. I'm sorry, I'm spacing where the article was, but I remember seeing a headline this morning saying like, Halo 3 is still an amazing game, and I was like, yeah, it is.
Already a headshot.
Three in a row, baby.
Three in a row.
Four. Lost the streak. Yay. Actually, I was gonna oh goodness. Speaking of Halo Infinite, I was gonna forward that gameplay snippet to Gordon. And don't tell him it was Halo. Hopefully he wouldn't notice, you know, and just be like, hey, what do you think of this cool game, man? Like, check out this awesome gameplay. And then surprise him.
Ooh, I got a little lag going on here.
Do you think I should do that, Elena?
I wasn't listening fully, sorry.
No. I was just saying I could cut together a just that gameplay of the Halo Infinite thing that they showed off today. And then just like upload it on my personal account or something and be like, hey, Gordon, check out this awesome game, dude. And like have him watch it. And then be like, yeah, that game looks awesome. And be like, yeah, dude, that's Halo.
I don't think he'd ever yield on that point.
Well, but I mean, if he doesn't realize it's Halo, he might be like, oh, yeah, this game looks cool. And then I can be like, I don't think he'd notice it was Halo. He doesn't know enough about Halo to...
Maybe. Oh, I found a Warthog. You guys want to ride a Warthog?
Warthog!
Wait, I can't flip it. Never mind. It's dead.
Well, they just dropped one. I'll drive.
Oh, great. Out, Marine. Out. I want to just sit and where's
Willis?
He's in the back, isn't he?
Nope.
Hold on. Oh. Falling behind.
Okay, I was about to say, I was like, oh no, did he crash again?
No. Oh boy, that would be bad. Stream would hate me.
Yeah, you know.
Where are you guys?
Honk honk.
Honk honk.
Wait, you can honk the horn? How do you honk the horn?
You just pull the right trigger, it honks it.
Oh, I had no idea all this time and I never knew.
Alright.
Yep. It's like the most weak ass honk for such a beastly vehicle.
You know, I have to say that was the funniest part of watching the trailer.
Was the drift on the...
Yes, the drift on the new Warthog. Adam, what is happening here?
I'm just style points.
I'm
oh,
dead,
no,
thanks.
I'm dead, too.
Oh, no. What's going on?
Thank you.
Well, you know, I'm the one driving. If you guys were shooting people, we would have been fine.
You want me to actually do something?
Oh, my gosh. You got banshees up ahead?
Oh. Yeah, I was also wishing that... that they drove around a little bit more, but that's just me. Pew pew! Oh, don't worry, Zach. He will never change his console hating ways. It's fun.
That's a given.
Yeah. So, little known fact, one of the downloadable songs on my favorite Guitar Hero, Guitar Hero 3 Legends of Rock, was the main Halo theme for Halo 3. So we have that at the office. I should...
Whoa, that was close.
Nice.
That was close.
I know.
I'm bailing.
Nah, Will's out. Got it. Yep, see, Will's got it. That wasn't anything. That was easy. Oh, I'm dead.
Oh, I'm dead too.
Oh no.
That one.
Oh, I guess we're all dead.
We're all dead. I tried to hop out.
An Eskimonster? Sorry, I'm not going to reveal Gordon's age here.
He is timeless. There is no age to Gordon.
Yeah. He could be 25 or he could be 250. You never know. Mm-hmm. Nice. Though I gotta say, when he was in his younger days at Maximum PC, he still acted pretty old too at the time. Oh no!
Oh, no. Whoops.
That wasn't a good spot.
Oh, I'm down.
Sorry, I think I.
Oh, I'm down too.
Oh boy!
Did you friendly fire me?
And I'm down again. Oh man.
I just helped finish you off. I'm just going to suggest maybe we not drive straight into them. There's a Wraith coming, by the way. Or a Wraith.
Oh,
oh
boy.
That's just no fun. Yeah, well, no, that I was trying to hop that little gap, but it didn't work.
Ugh, I'm down.
All right, I'm dead.
Okay. Oh, no.
Okay. No, we
just
are not.
Saying,
Jeff, we are not on Legendary.
No, we're not that good.
we also shouldn't be this bad. No, last time we got through, we got through most of the Halo 3 on Heroic.
That's a ghost. Peace. Bye, guys.
Good luck.
All right, let's do this again.
Yeah, I just need to be safe. Take some wider angles. You know? We kind of loop around a little bit, let our health get back.
I got killed? How did that happen? I didn't even see that dude. All right,
I'm gonna loop to the left. Give us a little bit of cover. Oh, and I died. Dang it.
Okay, I'm out.
Oh, I'm back.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. Get off, sucka.
Oh, you got the ghost.
Oh, and I'm dead. Hey, Eskimonster just gave us 20 Danish krones. Thank you.
Thank you.
And
I'm
triple thank you. We will need it. We will need that extra.
How are we doing so badly today?
Willis can blame it on his router settings.
On my router, yes.
We are kicking ass
all on the router. And of course, just when you mentioned it, now I'm crashed.
Oh, did you?
Oh boy.
No!
Oh no!
Bad. This is bad. Oh no! What's going on?
Oh man.
Oh, Alejandro, that wasn't charitable, man. Come on. They're dying too.
Yeah, we're all dying. Everyone has to see me die.
Are you guys crashed too?
Yeah, we're crashed.
Yeah, it crashed hard for all of us.
Yeah.
Like, I have a hard lock.
Yeah, back at the title screen.
Wait, so is it a Microsoft thing?
No, we just need to. I mean, honestly, we should have opened these ports on your router, long ago. But we were playing with fire. You know what? I want to check mine now, actually, right now. I'm going to fire up the settings app and see.
Yeah, I mean,
it still says
like,
I'm connected.
Honestly, when Leif and I were troubleshooting this for like the streams I've been doing on Twitch, my personal streams, we had so much problem with this until we both got to open NAT.
Yeah, it's just weird because, I mean, we've had two game sessions so far that were fine, but today it's not doing good for us.
I don't think this is a DNS issue for everyone in YouTube chat commenting. I mean, Google DNS is great, so is Cloudflare, when they're not going down because of DDoS attacks. This is a port forwarding issue, I think.
Yikes. Is there anything he can do quick, or should we just not do today?
I mean, what's your setting look like right now? Are you still blocked on server connectivity?
Yes.
Ooh. I don't know. What are you
That's
looking
so
at?
Weird.
What's it look like for you on your end, Adam?
I mean,
should I reset my router?
No, that's not going to help in the long term. I'm still connected to the server, so it just says moderate NAT type. So
yeah, you should be able to.
So my NAT type is saying moderate, but its server connectivity is also blocked.
Yeah, that's weird.
And fixing it is not doing anything either.
And you have game mode on, right? If you go to the tab right above it, it says game mode.
Yes.
It's on. Not that that's necessarily going to do anything, but.
I swear I didn't change anything since our last gameplay.
How could you?
How could I? I blame Halo. They just don't want me to continue or finish the fight.
Yeah.
Halo doesn't let me finish the fight.
I think it was a Gravemind. He hacked into your game.
Oh, boy. Master Chief's like, just don't finish the fight.
Don't.
Just don't. You know what? It's not even worth it. Well, while you do that, I'm gonna play some multiplayer.
Yeah, please do.
Yeah.
I'll watch and comment.
Let's do Halo 3. That Slayer. Yeah, cool. Well, let's try that. Yeah, let's try it. I'm actually curious to see how many people are online playing Halo 3 multiplayer specifically. Oh, wow. Okay. I found a lot of people. But they're all way higher level than I am. Oh, God. I hate this level. Slayer. Whoa, whoa.
Huh?
Oh, this is free for all? Oh, no, it is. Oh, dang it. Alright, well, now that I know that. Oh, and he stuck me. Slayer. Nice. I was lucky. Oh, man. Slayer. There we go. I'll beat him down. I'll take that. Ah! I shouldn't switch to that. Falling behind. I'll take that. Ah! Ah, dang it. Boot. 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 Ah, dang it. Sorry. shields down. Nice. Assassination. Oh, no.
What's involved in an assassination?
It's like hitting somebody from behind.
Oh.
Ah, dang it. Man, I haven't played Halo 3 multiplayer in so long. Feels
great.
Oh,
we did play at one point, didn't we?
It wasn't Halo 3 though.
No, that's true.
Yeah, like Halo 3 multiplayer is like the one I played the most of. Back in the day, so. Ah.
It's super funny because I can't hear your audio.
I know, I'm sorry.
So, no, it's okay.
You just hear me grunting.
It's just funny, though, because all I hear is you going, ah.
I mean, especially this is like free-for-all, so like time-to-death ratio is like super quick. Oh, man. I really want to get Brad in some Halo 2 multiplayer.
Oh, yeah, I'm totally waiting for him to show up so he can just carry us all.
Nice. Okay, I'll take that. Oh! Beat me to it. I mean, at least I'm not last. That makes me feel good, at least. Even though I haven't played Halo 3 multiplayer in so long.
You're definitely not last. You're like ranked fourth. So
probably something like that. It's moving around. It's a moving target. I just beat down somebody at the same time. I love that.
Like simultaneously killed each other with a melee.
What? Yeah. I love doing that.
It is pretty funny.
Boo-hoo. Oh, nope. What's the toggle? Oh, game over. Ah. What's the toggle for switching grenades?
Well, I got D-pad. D-pad.
Oh, okay.
Online, it is.
I got middle of the button. Middle of the pack. I'll take it. Excuse me. Oh, man, they're all dropping. Come on back.
Just too good for him, man.
I know.
Just too good for them.
How's the troubleshooting going?
Oh man, going way too in depth in this Toretto connectivity thing right now.
Well, luckily Elena's there, and it's a good practice for a video. Got to plug in my ROG phone. Too bad I'm not gaming on my ROG phone.
ROG. So, Adam Eskamonster says, you might want to turn up the mouse speed. It seems so slow to me.
Oh, I know, right? Yeah, this mouse speed is PE4 doers, what's going on? Man, for some reason I just can't find anybody right now. Let's try it again.
Oh, Adam.
Yes.
Timothy Bryce, would like to know, how is the Steam controller treating you?
You know, it's a little lonely.
I was gonna say, you gonna break the news to him?
Yeah, I haven't really. It's in my pile of controllers in storage right now. I have not been using it, unfortunately. I think I will get back to it, but as of right now, when the lockdown started, it was really hard for me to wrap my brain around learning something new and dealing with the stress of the lockdown at the same time. I'm going to use that. How about that? yeah. Slayer. I don't know why this thing doesn't want to focus on me. Okay, let's try that again. I should be back. There we go. Ah, damn it.
Adam, PE4 viewers would like to know if you have a stack of controllers.
I do have a stack of controllers. It's, to be fair, it's mostly 8-bit do controllers. Since I was, you know, I always review those. Side note: did anybody see the 8-bit do Microsoft collaboration?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, they're working with Microsoft to make a version of the SN30 Pro, not the Plus, that is Xbox branded, for for use with xCloud on mobile.
Oh, so yeah, that'd be interesting to get in for review.
Yeah, I mean, it, at least from what I've seen, it's actually not, from a hardware perspective, it's the same other than just kind of a skin on, you know, and it like has the Xbox branding on it. It looks nice. It's all black. I really like that. But on the software side, it does sound like they've incorporated some of the stuff that came in the SN30 Pro Plus. So a Windows app that lets you change some of the configuration options. Which is cool, because that was a really nice, piece of software. So, yeah, I'm good on them. I think that's a great pairing. I think that's the my go-to setup for cloud streaming stuff on your phone, because that controller is just so small. It's so portable. It's a nice little setup. Yeah. Anyway, why was I talking about that? Oh, stack of controllers. Yeah. So I have that. I've got my Steam controllers. I have my Xbox controllers. I have my PlayStation controllers. I have my Switch controllers. I have a lot of controllers. I try to pare them down. But also I have this stack of four or five SN30 Pro controller boxes, that I need to give away. Which, side note, I really, really want to do some giveaways on Discord, so I think I might just start doing those. Just random giveaway time.
We can set up a bot for it.
I would like to know if anybody here has used an 8-bit Do controller.
I assume that I don't count.
For
the purpose of that question.
Yeah. I don't want to be in a vacuum. So somebody did, you know, every once in a while we'll see the comments pop up on YouTube. I try to keep up with, like, YouTube comments, but it's hard on old videos to always, like, keep up. But I did have somebody ask me about the SN30 Pro Plus. I guess there's been people having, like, problems with it. Connectivity wise, yeah. So I responded to him. I mean, I've been using it on the Switch primarily, so I haven't personally been having any problems there. But that doesn't mean they're not there. Ah. Rick Elder, yes. The link is actually in the YouTube description right here. I'm if it's not, there's something wrong, and I should be fired. Because each one of our YouTube videos should have the full nerd Discord and link. If it, okay, maybe it's not in this gameplay link, but at least if you go to an episode of the full nerd, it'll always be down at the bottom of the YouTube link or the YouTube description.
So hello to Matthew Lang. Thanks for joining us again.
Matthew Lang. Wasn't Matthew the birthday boy from a little bit ago?
I believe so.
Happy birthday again. We'll call it a birthday month.
That's how I celebrate. I'm not content with one day.
Oh. Ah. Ah. Didn't know where the shots were coming from.
Pew pew.
Yes. Another simultaneous beatdown. You know, I'm always glad to play, like, with randos and not be the last of the pack, like the one pulling down the group. So I'm happy about that. Wait, where am I getting shot from? Ah!
How you doing over there, Willis?
He's probably having so much fun. He loves not playing Halo 3 and just troubleshooting routers instead.
Yeah, so I actually want I was having so much frustration with my last router.
Another like this, simultaneous.
It was like this older Linksys that I couldn't actually flash with open with a DDT. And I was just like, that's it, I'm done. And I just, I spent like, I think 250 or 300 to get a Ubiquiti, like the bare bones for a Ubiquiti setup. Because I was like, I don't want to have to deal with figuring out port routing. I don't want to have to figure out, you know, this stuff. I want to be able to set up different subnets. And I was just like, I'm just going to scorch earth this problem. And in retrospect, maybe I let my emotions get the better of me, but I really love it, so.
I always like a scorched earth. You know, that's how, that's what I do when I drive the Warthog. It's just scorched earth. You know, it's just like, ah, go for it. What is it? Let God sort him out later? Oh, crap. I just.
That's a Duke Nukem reference?
Something like it.
If you weren't so preoccupied, I feel like you would do quite well with invoking the Duke Nukem voice for that.
Sorry. Yeah.
No,
and also,
you're occupied.
Somebody has responded to me on YouTube chat about 8-bit Duke controllers. I just haven't had a chance to look at the chat or read it fully.
Let me look at that for you. I'm simultaneously trying to do some work in a different window while we're not playing. Let's see. Oh, where is it? Oh, okay. So Timothy Bryce on YouTube says,
yes.
I use a couple of 8-bit do controllers. I have two of the wireless add-in circuit boards for the original NES and the SNES controllers.
Oh, yeah, those are nice. I actually never did that. So you could actually take an original NES and SNES controller, and they sold a wireless circuit board. So you just open up the original controller, plop in this new circuit board, close it up, and you got a wireless version of the original hardware.
Oh, that's awesome, because the buttons would feel exactly the same.
Exactly, yeah. Super cool.
Oh, yeah, and then you could buy dead controllers and just... Oh, that's brilliant.
Yeah, I mean, I love what 8-bit do does. I mean, it's... You know,
that's brilliant.
It's some of their stuff is hit or miss, but for the most part, I think it's hit. That's cool. Hopefully they dig. Is there anybody out there who's been hoping to try some 8-bit Duke controllers? Like you got it in your cart, but you just haven't pulled the trigger. 'Cause I feel like, again, you know, there's always a lot of people who are looking for new controllers but don't want to pay like full price or don't want to do something dumb like me and pay, you know, $150 or $180 for the Elite.
I mean, it's not dumb. You're just putting your money where you feel your priorities are.
True. Not dumb. I'm just, you know, I did it to myself. I'm calling names to myself, not anybody. Gain the lead. Oh, I love this level. This level is fun. Nice. Oh, wow. Gained the lead. Lost the lead. Double kill. Nice. Yeah, I'm not doing too bad. Oh, man. You know, it's so funny how some of this is just like muscle memory, you know?
Yeah.
Like you just play so much of a game and like just to like jump back into it, especially a multiplayer game, is just like pure muscle memory. double kill. Ah. Ah. Ah.
Elena, you're not playing with Adam on multiplayer?
Oh, no, it's fine. I want to do this work anyway, so. I can kind of keep an eye on chat. I can just listen to Adam's ongoing
my grunts.
Non-verbal, non-verbal iterations of displeasure.
Did somebody mind changing the YouTube title, though, to just Halo 3 multiplayer? And not co-op campaign. Whoa! I did not
Can
even
I do
see that,
that
guy.
While you're in the middle of a stream, though.
Yeah. It'll update.
Okay.
That's what happens when I have typos that aren't caught before the show.
Oh, okay.
Oh That's man, he stuck fingers. Me. If not, I can do it.
That's fine.
Once this match is over. Whoa! Wow. Don't know what happened there.
Rick nope. Elder asks me, or said that he was playing a point-and-click adventure game, Thimbleweed Park.
Mm.
One of the characters reminded him of me because of their voice. She's an 80s game developer. Badass. I'll have to look at a game up. That's awesome.
I remember doing the like a little review video with Hayden when that first came out. It looked cool. I own it somewhere. I'm sure of that, but I have not played it. Sounds cool though.
You know, I don't really have that much experience with point and click adventure games because I didn't play games on PC. You know, the 90s are really like the heyday for point-and-click adventure games. I missed all of that.
Yeah, I did play some point-and-click adventure games, but they were like kid ones. Or the Star Trek one that I had mentioned on the show before. Ah! Nice! Man, I am just wrecking shop here. I love this level. Whoops, I think I killed my own guy. Whoops. Oh no! You know, I'm actually really bummed that this game doesn't show who's on controller and who's on mouse and keyboard. Like they do on Call of Duty. I would love to see if any of these people that I'm playing against are on a controller. Look at that. I led.
If they did that, I would probably show up as the only person. Everyone would probably look at it and go, ha, idiot.
Wow. Whew, that was good. I did pretty good that time.
What would Gordon say?
Let's not. We don't need
to.
That's fine.
That was fun. Man, I love that level.
All right, I changed the video title. I don't really think
Thank
it's
you.
The most imaginative, but it's at least accurate now.
Hey, we're nothing if not accurate. Right? No?
I try to be.
Anyway, while we're searching for players here, Elena, I know you're going to see a little bit of a delay, but this is the RK 2020. For some reason, my autofocus is not working. Let's try that. Yeah, this is the RK 2020, the new gaming hardcore gaming portable emulator. This thing, quad core 1.3 gigahertz CPU, and
so good.
It's one gig of RAM. So now this thing is able to play Dreamcast and N64 games. And I tell you what, like, I mean, it's not perfect, but these things have been coming out at such a clip, and like each one just surpasses the other, and like the price pretty much maintains. God damn it, I keep forgetting I have the battle rifle. It is really cool to be able to play. I mean, I think it's 75. So like to have this in the palm of your hand, $75. Oh, it's fun. I dig it.
I mean, I think you would enjoy it most because you like handhelds, but I actually think I would not want to play some of those N64 titles on such a small screen.
Yeah, I mean, there's that, and then also the control setup is not perfect for N64. I mean, that's, you're never going to get, you know, the classic experience with some of that stuff, so I think it's, N64 is just always going to be a hard one. But luckily, Dreamcast, I mean, my favorite, one of my favorite consoles of all time is, it's got everything I need on there and more. Yeah, performance on those systems is not like super great, but I mean, I can imagine in what, 2 months down the road, the next one comes out and it'll work flawless, and then push up to like original Xbox emulation, but you know, not like great. that's what keeps happening. Yeah, one of the interesting things around this one that I haven't really had to touch on too much in other ones is that this is, hardware-wise, they actually stole the hardware. Not stole. There's another handheld device out there called the I always forget how to say it. The Ogodroid. Something like that. I can't remember.
Sorry, I shouldn't laugh. I just think it's funny.
I mean, yeah, it's... Anyway, they came out with it. They came out with this handheld device, and then this other manufacturer in China, or I actually think they're based out of Hong Kong, literally took the same hardware, reconfigured it, and then just shipped it with the same firmware on it. And supposedly they did get into trouble, and they were like sending these things out without firmware for a while. So like you'd get this like, you know, console, and then you'd have to install your own OS on it. But now it actually ships with RetroArch from Emulex version of RetroArch, and this is like the first legit front end where I'm like, ooh, this is a nice polished front end. Because usually it's like a, you know, weird Linux front end that's kind of weird to use and not great. Anyway, I'm going on and on.
No.
Halo Infinite, yeah.
So about Halo Infinite, during that whole demo and gameplay, is there any like specific spoiler? That, you know, since I haven't played 4 or, yeah.
I mean,
you know, anything beyond that, is there anything that spoiled it?
If you care about the game, I mean, to a degree, there might be a kind of spoiler-ish vibe to it, because you're going to realize that, you know, certain things have happened in the universe.
Uh-huh. I mean, he's still alive.
But all you really need to know with Halo games is that you're Master Chief, something's wrong, and you gotta go fix it.
Yeah, I mean, personally, like, I hate spoilers. I'm always, like, yelling at Lindsay. I'm like, no spoilers! So, like, I'm pretty sensitive to that stuff. But in this case, I actually don't feel like it was that spoiler at all. other than knowing that it's Master Chief and he's on a Halo of some sort. But I mean, that's every goddamn Halo game.
No, they did. There is a bit in it where there is a mild spoiler about what's happened in the universe with the war.
Yeah, so. I don't think Willis would pick up on it since he hasn't been deep up enough in it. You know what I mean?
I mean, I think he would pick it up, but I don't know if he would care, let's put it that way. Again, these games are really just about, like, oh, there's a problem in this universe. Master Chief's a badass. He gonna go fix it. Let's go shoot things.
Shoot more guns.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
But it looks damn nice. And it seemed to be running really smooth.
I don't know how I feel about the grapple.
Oh, yeah, would you rather have a jetpack?
I think I would.
Yeah. We've had jetpack before.
I know.
It didn't feel like over-the-top Doom grapple, which was kind of nice. Man, I'm doing horrible this round. I don't know. I think to a certain degree, Halo's always kind of had a problem with movement, right? I mean, we're playing Halo 3 and there's still no damn run button. Like, you know, it's they've always kind of done movement their own way. So I like that they're at least trying something different. To say, hey, you know what? Like, this is the fastest you've ever been able to move with a Master Chief. Like, literally. Hey, Dennis is here.
Hey, Dennis, what's up?
Yeah.
Now we can start talking about food.
Yeah, please do it. Eskimonster, no, you can't dodge. There's no dodge or roll in Halo. Yeah, I'm doing horrible this round. Ah. Well, at least I led my team. I'll take that. Game over. Nice. Oh, Rick got an HDMI converter for the Dreamcast. Nice. I know there's a really nice HDMI converter for the N64. HDMI converter N64. Where is it? It is excuse me. Oh, is it the Super 64? Yes, this is it, the Eon Super 64. I've heard good things about that. I mean, I would even be one to try to mod a Dreamcast for output, but if you can dodge a Master Chief, you can dodge a ball. You know, I recently thought to myself, I should watch Dodgeball again. It's been a bit. Yeah, it's one of those things I've always wanted to do is do more console modding. Team Slayer. Yeah, I either just haven't had the hardware or the time or the knowledge. Where is everybody?
I don't know.
Ah! Whoa. They're behind me. Oh, he's got the sword.
Are you red team now?
I am red team, yes. Red team wins. Didn't even see that guy. You know what's funny? We've almost every weekend, Willis and Luis and I have been playing Warzone. And I've seen the same pattern here where maybe just because I'm old, that we'll like get really, we'll do really good at the very beginning. And then as playtime goes on, we'll start to like peter out and not do very good. I feel like I'm doing this here again. Like I started out really hot.
That happened a few times. There were a few matches where we did pretty strong at the very end of our gameplay.
Oh man!
I mean, what was it, the last one we got a few gold and platinum status?
We did. But that man, that one round we had was like awesome. It was so good. Oh. We got some campers in here.
So no dice, Willis, on your troubleshooting?
I'm doing every solution from the support Xbox.com is showing me. And I mean, everything looks good, but... and. When I go back to the Xbox networking to check again, it's still no dice, which is odd because nothing has disabled, so I don't know what's going on.
I just wonder if you... I mean, do you have UPnP enabled on your router?
Oh no, two.
Sure.
Ah, damn it. Oh yeah.
So either you want to do the universal plug and play, or you want to do actual manual port forwarding.
Which side note, Elena?
Hmm?
We got a question for you in chat. Oh, Dennis Siberian said that you left the stream early on Tuesday and didn't get to answer what your favorite beer was.
Oh.
I could have answered for you, but that's not fair.
Actually, I want to know what you think my answer would be.
Hard cider.
I mean, that's not a beer, though.
I know.
That's not a beer.
But
I mean, Adam is correct. I prefer hard cider over beer. So if I was given a choice to go outside the boundaries of the question, I would go that direction. But if I had to stay within beer, I would probably pick Guinness.
Oh, nice and dark and smooth. I like it.
It has more weight to it. Tastes like bread, kind of. I prefer that. I don't really like the taste of beer in general. But I can tolerate like little half pints of Guinness, which I love is a thing in Europe, or at least in Britain.
Half
when
pint.
When I was in London, I was so happy because they got little Elena sized glasses for me.
Well, because you know you can have a half pint at breakfast or lunch. You know, you got to be able to have more options at different meal times. Makes sense to me. Yeah. I was just about to drop the F-bomb because I'm so angry at that person.
What, Willis?
Hey.
Beer.
Tsingtao? No, not that. No, not even Tsingtao. Growing up, my dad would actually, not me growing up drinking, but my dad would drink Henneken.
Henneken or Heineken?
Heineken.
I feel like Heineken is like the choice of Chinese dads
I know.
In America.
Is that a thing? I didn't know.
Yes.
That's funny.
I don't know why, but it's just his go-to. And then when I started to, appreciate more, types of beer out there, I was like, oh hey dad, try other stuff, like
try something else other than Heineken
out. He's like nah.
Oh, also a Chinese dad thing.
Yeah.
Well, if you think bad, Adam, my dad was a Budweiser guy, and I was just like, what, dad? I mean, he drank Heineken too, but more often Budweiser.
I mean, it's weird though. I feel like, I mean, if you're drinking a Bud, you might as well, you know, you like it. That's it's like Gordon, right? If he likes a Bud, drink a Bud, cool. But there's certain ones like a Heineken or a
You're saying people can't like Heineken?
Well, no, I'm saying like if you're going to drink a Heineken or a I'm trying to think of what the other like a Stella, like you might as well just drink a Budweiser Stella. At that point. Like it's Stella. Like it's trying to be a fancy Budweiser and it's doing a horrible job of it. Like I don't know. Personally, I yeah.
Ooh, that was a rough death.
But
yeah, this math is hard. Ooh.
Yeah. But anything like Hefeweizen, I like Hefeweizen more wheat beer.
So do you like the beers at 21st Amendment? Because I feel like they tend to be very weedy.
Yeah. I actually don't like 21st Amendment that much because of that. Oh, we took the lead. Oh! Whew! Sorry.
Rick Elder in chat just told me that I should try Bell's Special Double Cream Stout. It says it's seasonal, so I'll have to keep my eye out for it. I don't know if we even get it in this area. I don't think I've ever seen that company before.
Yeah,
I don't buy alcohol often, though. So.
I love dark beers. I'm always either drinking a stout or a porter. That's just my jam. I like the dark hops.
Are you answering Dennis's question, or are you just actually riffing? Okay.
No, yeah, I was. Sorry. I'm in and out of chat here. I think I've mentioned this before, but one of the cheap beers that I miss is Yingling. Yingling Lager is only available in the Northeast United States, and it was cheaper than PBR in Pittsburgh. Whoa. When I lived there, but it tasted like so much better. Like it was a really good lager, and they actually, I feel bad or not bad. I feel bummed because they actually had other things, other variations, of Yingling, but I never tried them cause I just always enjoyed the basic one. And so, yeah, I wish I would have played around a little bit more with trying out the different variations of it. It's one of those things where you don't know you miss it until it's gone. Oh, who's shooting me? Dang it.
It me. Oh, you were saying. So is it is it spelled with a Y, or is it actually like Yingling, like German?
Y-E-U-N-G.
Oh, okay.
I think is a Yingling.
When you said that, I was like, is that a Chinese maker?
No, it took me a while to learn how to say it when I lived in Pittsburgh. Oh man, walked right into that. Dennis asked a good question. I actually like it both, especially a nice thick creamy stout. I feel like is a good dessert. So maybe not a meal necessarily, but a dessert. But if I'm having a meal, I want a lighter beer typically. Hmm. But if I'm just drinking a beer, then I'm okay with it being thicker. Man, hit the wrong button.
I'm okay with partially drinking my meal.
Ah, I love this map. I'm just realizing this is a really good map. Not just realizing, I'm having not played it in a long time. You know, I think we're diverging a little bit too much from food talk to beer talk.
What's wrong with that? It's still consumables.
I was just saying. Typically, we don't talk about the beer. Usually, people are talking about food.
I mean, it's part of the whole dining thing, right? I never got into wine either, so I still don't know what pairs with what for food.
Yeah, my ex-wife was a server for a long time, and she specialized in Japanese food and like wine pairings and stuff like that. And yeah. And so I learned a bit through osmosis and tried to like it, but yeah, it's just not. I couldn't stick with it.
But that sounds like an American kind of invention to pair Japanese food with wine.
Sure. I mean, she wasn't Japanese, so.
Okay.
I mean, she worked at some traditional Japanese restaurants.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
I mean, yeah. They still offered a lot of wine. Because, hey, high margins on alcohol.
Very high margins.
I don't think there's too many traditional Japanese restaurants that would not sell wine just because it's not traditional.
Oh, no. I mean, you have to tailor yourself to the market, but I was just trying to wrap my brain around it because I was like, I don't remember that being a thing when I was in Japan.
Well, no, I mean, yeah, it's not a thing in Japan, I don't think.
Also, thanks to the chat, I just typed a sentence that started with AMD's rise in food. So thanks, everybody.
AMD's rise in food is the best meal for wannabe PC makers.
I actually associate rice wine more often with Chinese and maybe even Korean. I'm not sure about the Korean part. But plum wine is a Japanese thing.
I love plum wine.
Ah, where'd he go? Where'd he go? I lost him. Nope, that's my guy. Foo, 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 foo.
Elena, have you tried the brand Choya? Or plum wine?
No, I'm not a plum wine person either. I don't really drink that much, and if I do, it really is like usually a hard cider or even like a hard liquor based drink. I'm fond of I always mix up the order.
Man, I suck that around.
Vodka cranberry? Cranberry vodkas? I don't know, yeah. I think it's vodka cranberries. So basically, I think to kick a screwdriver, you just swap in cranberry juice instead.
Dennis asks, is that like fruit wine?
Which one?
Plum wine.
I guess.
I mean, yeah. I mean, it's plum.
But it's not sweet, I don't think. Is it?
Oh, it's super sweet, actually.
Oh, is it?
Yeah,
okay.
So it's dangerous to consume, you know, a lot when you're not aware that it tastes like alcohol.
I'm gonna try some competitive game types. See if I can.
Isn't that what you were doing?
No, I was just doing social, which is like an unranked. This is now ranked. Just to see, shits and giggles.
Okay, so quick update. My NAT type says it's open, but my server connectivity is still blocked.
What?
What's going on?
All right, let me look this
weird.
Up. Sorry.
Hey, at least you got your NAT open, though. That's good, because...
Yeah.
That is integral for a lot of reasons, not just for this game.
What?
And just wanted to know, are you guys also connected to the company's VPN?
No.
No.
That'll screw up. That'll screw up gaming.
That might, yeah. Okay. Disconnect from that. See what happens.
Disconnect from that real quick.
You were connected to it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I mean, even for the past couple
really?
Of games,
oh, yeah.
I was connected to it, so...
I only connect to the VPN when I need to, and then I immediately
same.
Disconnect.
Like, our VPN...
Yeah.
Yes, I just don't like dealing with it.
That's funny. I'm surprised you've never had any problems yet.
Right. Hello, Jeff. Thanks for joining us.
But that would be funny if that was... I mean, I could easily see it.
Oh, Dennis, we have not finished the single-player campaign. What happened was that we started it, and then we think it's Willis not to put all the blame on Willis, but we
I
think
mean, it
it's
could
Willis's,
be me.
I'm sorry.
It's Willis's connection that was making it causing our the game to hang, freeze, and then crash, and then kick us all out. So, because we didn't want to bore you while we troubleshoot, Adam's playing some multiplayer, so you can see what that's like.
Yeah, just to you know, have fun, just to show everyone how bad I am.
Oh, I actually really like this, Matthew. So Matthew Lang says, AMD should have made their packaging look like packaging for yeast because it's rising. And I'm done for the day with dad jokes. Ryzen, excuse me, I can't pronounce it right.
Oh, hey, speaking of Ryzen, I really liked that that Zen PC build that you had.
Oh, so pretty.
Yeah, right?
Some people are just so creative and artistic with what they do with their builds.
And it's like, and actually, until you had linked that, I totally had forgotten that like the code name for Ryzen was Zen before it came out.
What?
Yeah.
How many times have you been in videos with Gordon and he's mentioned it?
I mean, but now Zen refers to the node, or not the node, the process type, right? You know, like we're on.
Zen is the
Zen
name
3
of the microarchitecture.
I know, but like it's like, you know, I. Before the CPU, any of the CPUs came out, you know, I just associated it. Ah, Jesus Christ. It had a different association in my mind. And so, yeah, that was, I was like, oh, I totally forgot that Ryzen, the CPU, used to have a code name of just Zen.
Willis, when you turn off the VPN, what does the gaming, the Xbox gaming window say about your server connectivity? Does it change anything?
So, having to disable that, I just checked again and... Yep, still says unable to qualify. Right. So, still blocked.
Alright, let me look. You might have to actually go into the command line, command prompt. Which is a command line interface. And then actually enable Teredo manually, if I remember right. Let me look.
I did follow some steps from Windows prompting me to do some of the command line. I see some of the values are, like, it's technically not disabled, so I don't.
And do you have your Windows firewall on?
Let's see. It is off.
Oh. Do you have no firewall up in general?
Spoilers.
Yes. It is all, I don't know if Adam told you this, but IT is really messing with my workstation.
Oh, do you have like, are you using like, here, let me type this out to you.
Ah.
I'm messaging you in the Zoom chat.
Oh, Zoom chat. Okay. Yep.
Damn. No, I am definitely not in the lead. I am at the end of the lead.
Dennis, I have eaten pomegranate, and it's one of my favorites. I enjoy it quite a bit. I just don't enjoy the harvesting of the seeds part. Although, I've done this before when I was younger, where I would get a pomegranate and I would just wait and wait and wait. And my parents would say, like, the pomegranate is starting to go bad. Like, it's old. Like, it's shriveling up. I'm like, no, I got this. Because when it gets old, it's much easier to get the seeds loose. Which is what I discovered. I think when they're fresher, it's like much harder to get the seeds out from the membrane.
Insane in the membrane. Oh my goodness. Sniped.
Ooh.
Whew. This is a close match. I'm not doing bad, but I'm not doing good either. Adam doesn't have the lead. Well, thank you for being biased. Oh man, yeah. I mean, I held my own. I wasn't last place. Third to last. Out of eight. Whew. Some intense firefights here, people. Oh, Greg Salazar. He sounds familiar. Greg Salazar. What outfit is he, or what outlet is he from?
Greg Salazar?
Yeah, that sounds so familiar.
He's a YouTuber.
Oh, he's just a YouTuber. Okay.
Yeah, he did this great video. I remember him specifically because he did this video comparing different vertical GPU mount riser cables.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like watching this and I was like, this is fascinating. And like 10 minutes in, there's just this shot of his cat stepping around the cables and my brain just went complete mush. I'm like, kitty! It's basically what my brain did. Kitty cat!
I like it.
I'm like 5 years old, really.
Slayer. Whoop. Oh, I don't like this level. Dang it. Supposedly he was having audio problems. Yeah, the name sounds super familiar. Lost the lead. Oh no.
Okay.
Gain the lead.
So, Willis has shown an absurdly huge amount of trust in me, because I have
Do you have the codes?
I have control of the screen.
She has control.
Oh no. She's inside the firewall?
Uh-huh. Oh man, I tweeted about this a few weeks ago, but it cracks me up when I overhear like network TV shows and like the tech person is like, oh no, we can't figure out where this bad guy is because they've encrypted their IP. I was
like, yeah. They're tunneling in through the firewall. Just to use all the Bud's words. I'm not dead yet. Oops. Where is everybody? Oh, there he is.
All right, hold on.
second.
I need to move windows. Not going to be able to see you dying, Adam. Sorry.
No!
I will not be able to mourn you properly.
Oh, yes. I love simultaneous beatdowns.
Just don't die.
Just don't die. You know what? This round, I'm going to try not to die. Nice.
Oh,
well, I died. Yeah, that was nice, but then I died. Ah. Nice. Haha, I got a bounce on that one. That was nice. I love that there's somebody in here called Sauce My Pan. Oh no.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. Well, God, can't even do a jump. Sauce My Pain is owning me. What? Okay, jeez. I was about to say. Don't worry, I gave Sauce My Pain his comeuppance.
You panned his sauce?
You panned his
sauce. Oh, how did I not get that kill? Ah, should have had a double kill. Double kill. Ah! Sauce My Pan.
So weird.
I'm here to kick ass and sauce pans, and I'm all out of pans.
Oh, jeez, Adam.
You should turn on your voice chat in the gameplay and tell Saucepan that.
Oh no, I know better than to turn on in-game voice chat.
I think we would violate our own policies for what was acceptable to say on over the stream.
You know what I used to love doing, though, is that what game was it? There's a game in particular that I probably a Call of Duty where I was like into the maybe you've seen anyway, it doesn't matter, in a highly competitive game, and I was pretty good at whatever this one was. You're just gonna have to believe me. And I would we'd have like open chat on, and I would have Lindsay put on the headphone and just start like talking mad shit, and like everybody just got so angry because it was a girl. Oh man.
Oh, that must have been so much fun trolling.
Oh my,
them.
It was so fun. It was so fun.
Oh, I would love to hear her do it.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Hey, Elena, hold on one second. I think I know what you're trying to do. Give me one second.
Okay.
Because I have dual monitor on. That's why.
Okay. Thanks. I was like, how come I can't see the screen? Maybe it's buried under a window?
Slayer.
Yeah. So you're good. Yeah.
Thank you.
Gain the lead. Double kill. Oh, dang it. Horrible, horrible
okay,
throw.
Now I want to know, what kind of stuff was she saying?
Oh, I don't remember.
I bet she does.
Yeah. It was fun.
I'll have to ask her next time.
I got
a lot of
people angry.
Sounds good.
I'm just trying to remember what game it was. It had to have been a Call of Duty. gain the lead. Oh, cheat. Yeah, there's even people, I remember people being like, oh, there's no way this is a girl. There's no way. A girl can't be this good. No way. You know, all that typical stuff. Elena, don't lie. When you saw the high refresh rate Ori, you wanted to get a Xbox Series X.
No, actually, I was. I know you really have it on disappointed. PC. No, I was disappointed because the Moon Studios logo came out, and I got super stoked. So I was like, oh, "Are they announcing a new game already?" Do you know what I mean? And they're like, "No, it's just a visual update and some tweaks so that you can make the most of your new hardware." And I'm like.
Which brings it up to date with the PC version.
Yeah. Which I don't need to get because I got Game Pass, so. I got Game Pass.
Whoop, whoop. Nope, that was dumb. Shouldn't have done that.
Oh, wait a minute.
Gotcha. Yep. Think it might have. Thanks.
So what other games are you guys excited during that Xbox announcement?
Not really many, honestly. Just Infinite for me.
I mean, Infinite was, I mean, and also it was the one that showed the most in-depth gameplay. I mean, not a ton of gameplay. I'm excited for that that horror game, but that's just personal reasons. Wow. I can't remember the stupidest name ever. It's like the horror or something. Horror McHorror Face.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. I forgot the name too.
Yeah, right. It's just very generic, but the soundtrack's by Akira Yamaoka, so I will buy anything he's attached to. And then, yeah, what was... there was another one. I wasn't really excited for that Rare game. I've never been a really big Rare fan. So, I know a lot of people were excited about that one, but that one was kind of lost on me.
Rick Elder says Fable. I never got into that.
I have a friend, Mikey Dimmer, who comes on the stream every once in a while. He loves Fable. Fable's like his like favorite series ever. I texted him when I saw the logo because we've always been talking about it, but he, you know, just bummed that it was a logo, not like anything. It was like a joke, you know, a typical Halo joke, or not Halo, a Fable joke, fart humor. God, there was some stuff towards the end that I thought was cool. I don't give two craps about, State of Decay. I could care less about that.
Grounded looks pretty interesting.
The Medium.
It's like a Medium, yeah.
That's what it's called. Yeah.
The Medium.
Yeah, stupid name.
Grounded looks pretty interesting. It reminds me of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Yeah. I'm just surprised it was was it not Obsidian? Was it Obsidian? Yeah, it was Obsidian that's doing it. I was super. Why can't I think of the people who did Control doing the single player of that Crossfire game, which I have no interest in the multiplayer of the Crossfire, but like that, I mean, if they're on board for the single player, I'm on board. Whoops. Whoopsie daisy. Oh man, I am doing horrible.
One second.
Thanks. So every time for the stream, every time you hear me say something like or like I pause and Willis says, "Oh, I got it," it's what's happening. Is that because I have control of his system?
Remedy.
But I can only see one screen. It's the window I want is on his second monitor, and he has to move it over for me.
It's called
teamwork. Everybody.
It's called teamwork.
Teamwork. Also, Peter Jansen, the one thing that I really wish I had right now is also a pull-up bar.
Game over.
So much more exercise I could do. Oh, Willis, this could do it. This could do it. I read that this could be the reason why.
Let me sign in.
Whoops.
You're going to have to do that. I don't know what's happened on my end, but...
Complicated. IT issues.
Well, I probably only have time for one more round, so
no worries.
At least it'll be fixed
for next time.
Yeah, actually, after we're done, we should test it. Well, no, we shouldn't test. I don't have time to test it. But tomorrow.
Okay, let's reboot or something, and maybe. It's the dumbest thing. It's like the dumbest thing if this works. I hope it does. You can stop sharing your screen for now, Willis, okay. Though, if you want. It's the dumbest thing if this actually works. So basically, the Teredo service sometimes won't work if your time and date is not set to sync with the Windows servers.
Oh.
Like, I don't know anything about networking, really.
That
so
would be
there's
weird.
There's probably a good reason for it, but it cracks me up that could be the issue.
That would be weird.
Yeah. I just went back to Xbox networking. It's still giving me, not...
Well, I would reboot.
Okay.
I would reboot. Right. So just make sure that's still set to, sync with... the Windows servers, and then reboot.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll double check all that later. Oh boy.
Oh boy is right. Computers, huh? Who needs them? Somebody asked me something in the chat. Oh, do I miss any German or Turkish food? I was too young when I lived in Germany to have any real memories. But supposedly when I was a kid, one of my favorite things to eat was called Ekmek. It was like it was some kind of breaded, I don't know. I'd have to look it up. So yeah, Ekmek, and like supposedly these ladies. I remember seeing photos of like me as a little kid, blonde hair, blue eyed kid, standing next to somebody with this big like plate of Ekmek on their head, just like carrying it around, selling it on the street. Supposedly, I love the hell out of that stuff. In Germany, I mean, there's plenty of good German options. Around here where I live, I wouldn't say plenty. There's a couple good German options here, but there's one experience in particular. You guys have probably heard me talk about it before, but it was like my favorite German food experience, and probably like favorite food experience of all time. It was this guy called the Chicken Man, and he only had three things on his menu. It was chicken, French fries, and beer. And the chicken and French fries were just completely coated in paprika. So like you would go into the restaurant, you'd open the door to go into the restaurant, and like just this wave of paprika just like poured out of the door, and you knew you were there. It was awesome. It was so good.
I did not see what the question was.
It's if I miss any German or Turkish food.
But I was going to chime in about German food because I actually miss currywurst. It's like the best like bar food, bar hopping kind of food where you just need something to like soak up alcohol you're drinking.
Mm.
It's pretty good.
And Peter, I kind of burnt out on bratwurst. Like, I don't know. I feel like I've had too much in my life.
Do you have it with the sweet mustard? Because that is the shit.
Yeah, actually, the German place here on Alameda actually has really good sweet mustard. Really good. But yeah, I don't know. I just... It's not my go-to anymore. I would probably get schnitzel over bratwurst. 9 times out of 10. Whoops. And once again, I'm doing horrible on this map, too.
I really like goulash, which I think is actually not... I think Hungarian goulash is actually different than what we think Hungarian goulash is. Like, the stew version is actually something named differently in Hungarian. It's not called goulash. But when I've been to, like, German restaurants here in the city, it's the style that I like, called stew. That stuff's pretty great.
All right, it's official. I'm to the point where I'm like, I'm the heel of my team. I'm holding everyone back.
You're just gonna quit? Just rage quit?
No, I mean, the good thing this is the last, my last round, because, oh, yeah, I think I just have a stamina problem when it comes to multiplayer games. Getting old, you know?
Maybe. Oh, it cracks me up that people still do the XX thing for their names.
Yeah. Duh. I mean, it just means they're awesome.
Oh, Willis, you're back.
I'm back?
Gain the lead.
Did you reboot?
No, I did not.
You had to think that for a minute?
No, because I was trying to troubleshoot something else. Let me quickly reboot.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
No, I did not.
Too. Can I check to see? I'm gonna share my screen with you real quick.
Okay.
That's great.
No, I did not.
I wish this was Twitch. Can someone clip that? That was great.
Yeah.
That was fantastic.
I got distracted with all the food talk. I'm like, okay, I'm listening.
Oh yeah, Willis, we need to go to that. There's a really good German place here on Alameda.
Yeah?
Yeah, we should have you.
Okay.
Have you
Will,
over?
Can you see my screen?
Yes.
So, oops. Can you just go into this sending too to make sure that this right? Can you see my cursor?
Yeah.
Like, can you make sure that that's the same?
1 second. Mine's a little different.
Mm-hmm.
Man.
Can I see it?
Yeah.
I guess I wasn't the worst, but jeez. Okay, well, I think I got to level 2 with that one, hopefully. Did I? Whoops. Yeah, I did. Yay, level 2. Okay, well, let me...
Oops, sorry, 1 second.
Go back.
Leave this.
All right.
I actually, do you guys know Red versus Blue?
Yep.
Yeah. So I was introduced to that before I ever played Halo.
Mm-hmm.
And anytime anybody plays multiplayer, I actually have a clip from either like the first or second season where like the main characters in Red versus Blue like somehow get transported to a multiplayer match, and they're just their reaction is basically like, what hell did we just get dropped into? And I just have like snippets of that scene or those scenes in the back of my head anytime I watch somebody play multiplayer, which is great.
Well that's it for me today. I'm officially spent. Hopefully Willis will reboot at one point and and see if it'll work next time.
Sorry, everyone.
I'm gonna zoom in here for the close. Let's see if it'll. This is Adam Patrick Murray signing off. Thank you, Elena.
Thank you
for joining us. Thank you, Willis, for
Thank
troubleshooting.
You. We need to finish the fight soon.
Yeah, it's in your contract. It's mandated. You need to finish the fight. And also, we need to hurry and finish this fight so we can finish two other fights. No, three other fights before Halo Infinite comes up.
Yeah.
It's probably horribly out of focus.
Why is the camera so close on your face?
Yeah, it's probably horribly out of focus, right? So, yeah,
it's
there we go.
It's focusing on your microphone.
Yeah, cool. Close up on Adam for the end. Thank you, everybody. I'm tired. I'm gonna go sleep. So we'll see everyone later. Bye.
Bye.